Hello everyone, welcome back to the Fruity Mars channel. Yeah, so today it's not Saturday. Well, there might be a 1 out of 7 chance that it is true, but yeah, I sort of missed my schedule or whatever. But yeah, so today let's look at my latest track, It's About Time. If you want to know what it's about, post a comment or something. But some of you really seem to like the lead sounds, and I think it's pretty good actually. Let me tell you some things about the leads and the post-processing and the sounds and everything that's happening, because it's quite interesting, if I may say so. So this is the part I'm going to show you how I did it, the sound design basically. And this is funny because I screwed this one up in the final version, because in the final version it's actually over here. But it's not a big problem. The release went pretty quick because you know how it goes. You can't really finish a track. You're like, nah, I still need to change some things. And then it never gets released or whatever. So that's why I released it. And it turns out that it's streaming pretty well. So thank you. Don't forget to check out my Spotify. Now let's dive into those lead sounds. Alright, so right here is the melody. Let's first make sure it's on the right spot on the filter. This is how it sounds. And there are some interesting things in here. First, let's disable the... Well, yeah, we could disable the reverb and delay, but yeah, let's just do that, because we can hear it more clearly now. Way drier, but still pretty full. Now right here is a ride and a clap. Yay. So, really interesting. Now here is a bass. I think that's silent, yes. And that's a pretty interesting thing. Now, here's another bass. And I'm pretty sure that one is sidechain. Yeah, it is, to the proper chain right there. This right here is a pulse, and I use that to sidechain the things that need to be sidechained. Let's throw on the arp, and let's see what it does. So it was actually on the wrong setting. Well, track still turned out pretty fine. Now, so first let's take a look at the third bass right here. Third bass, okay. I think this is really groovy, really funky maybe, almost. Because you see, the track is in triplets. I was trying to avoid sounding like Pirates of the Caribbean, but right here, there's the note of the next bass note already in some sort of stairs. Trappetje, godver. And then right here, it has this long note, strange rhythms. And you see, that's the fun part about making melodies and stuff. And I've started doing this more recently. It's just experimenting with things. Don't always go the safe way, because that will eventually make you boring, I think. You see, music is not about releasing stuff and earning money or whatever and getting streams. It's about, I think it's about touching someone in a legal way. Okay, jokes are getting bad. Now, here we have some plugs. And I love this final part, because some people might really not like it, but just listen to it. Because something here is really rhythmical or something. So I like that. And in the track you don't really hear this, but you sort of feel it. Now the arp. Arp is kind of cool. This is a silent arp, pretty sure, yes? How does that one sound dry? So what did I do there? Vala room. All right, basic stuff. So that's a cool note, I think. Right here. And there we have the staircase again. So combined with the other two sounds, it really does something cool at the end when it repeats. You see what I mean? Because this one goes steadier, others don't, and somehow it still works. Then right here, this is not the full arp, because this is the full arp. This is how it sounds solo, and this is with a new sound. And that just does it, because if you turn off this one in the track, it just doesn't work that great. It adds some high stuff, and this is actually Laura from the Isolation contest. Isolation. See? And I chopped it up. And that's actually in my sample pack, I think. For the Mass Essentials, effects, other. I think this one is free now, so have fun. Vocal shot. Oh. It's I chopped new ones. But you can basically use these. Yeah, and you can do the same thing. It's pretty cool. Now then, let's dive into the leads and chords. So let's get on with the chords. This one is a silent from the Twitch stream. Headhunters used. He used his preset in the stock silent one bank called LD Follow, and I did a little stuff with it. Not just because it's Headhunters, because I really don't do much these days because it's Headhunters. But I try it, and if it works, I keep it. And don't get me wrong, there's post-processing on there, and I do change the preset. So take a look and you can change it. Everyone with Silent One has this preset. It's in the main factory bank. And then the next one is a Virus, and this one is really wide. And then when you combine them, you get some really cool chords, and when you turn on the arp and all that crap, it already sounds kind of cool. So yeah, let's dive into the leads. This right here is also a Virus, yes. Now the gliding notes, the legato here, might not sound really great, but in the track it works, in the layering. You see, that's something I learned on mixing school, or whatever it's called, the thing I learned there. Sometimes a great layering doesn't mean all the sounds sound awesome on solo. So in this case, it's not really bad, it's just not very attractive. Now, right here, that's lead 3, that's also a Virus. No, this is a silent, yep. And this is just a normal super saw, and I did a little pitch bend attack here. And then here we have a Virus again, yep. And the top one really does a lot. It's Serum, it's not really complicated, you can copy the settings if you want. Well, nothing really happening there. So this part, and you can copy it basically. I named it Crack Hunters, I don't know why. Sorry, Willem. And then the harmony is a Virus. No, it's a silent. And again, here's a trick with the harmony. It's not a MIDI or melody tutorial, but when you play the harmony layer on solo, it has to make sense somehow. Because if it sounds really strange, there might be something wrong. Let's play these two together and see how it sounds. Now, right here, not really sure about this note. I think what it was the best choice. And I like this part. Aha, it's actually the same note here. So there are some mistakes in this track, but it still works. So mistakes aren't always bad. Now let's just listen to all the leads together, including the, not including the harmonies. And let's just turn on the reverb and delay. So these are just four leads. And really, if you want to have those virus sounds, it's my virus bank. There are 17 unique patched virus sounds in there. 88 sounds per key, looped. You can have so much fun. I mean, they sound great enough for me to use them. You know, I have an actual virus DI sitting right here. I'm looking at it. And I still use my own bank because it's easier and you can layer the crap out of it. And when you want to change one note, you don't have to record everything all over again. Must say, the Virus TI has a built-in preset save function, so it's not that bad. But when you're making a melody, you really want to save time on the workflow. Again, really, if you haven't checked it out yet, and if you're interested in virus sounds, this is actually great stuff. I wouldn't be using it if it wasn't great. But then I also wouldn't be selling it, of course. Now, so let's turn everything back on again. Now, let's have a look at the second part. I think this is kind of cool. All right, before we listen to the final part, I want to show you a little bit about the mixing, about how I mix the leads. Now, here on lead 3, it's just a low cut and a little high boost. It's what I always do. Lead 2, same thing. Lead 1, wow. Lead 1 doesn't have much. They all have EQs and nothing more. Okay, this is not really complicated. But I'm pretty sure once they go to the all bus, really? So it's just minor EQs. Well, this seems like minor, but this is almost 3 decibels of change. But then they go to a melody bus, and yet their stuff really gets complicated. There's a grow speed for the effects. This one, I don't automate the on-off function because the timing might be off. So I do the volume of the effect. And right here is another EQ, not even dynamic. 2 kickstarts, I don't know why. Valhalla shimmer. And that's basically all of these are effects. Automated in the track itself. So it's kind of interesting. The mixing is really not that special. Huh, it's just very precise. Now let's go.